here in India as well. Now, trafficking of rescue girls, you know, according to my study, during 2007, 458 girls and women had been trafficked, but they were rescued by the mighty Nepal India. This is the NGO. They were rescued through the international border. You know, now I come. How to cope the challenges of the cross-border movement in Nepal India? I have some suggestions. I have suggested four alternatives. The first one is strengthening the border sales, only identify CCTV, leadership by ID cards, and managing the frontier. Ultimately, now I'm coming to the end of the plan. Strengthening the saving regimes. Both the countries have deployed security forces. India has deployed 45,000 special service bureau people, and Nepal has deployed 5,300. So, what I mean that it can be regarded as the first state to regulate the border between Nepal and India. Now, what is it about? It has to be monitored by the CCTV. If there is a criminal, if Yashin Bhargal, like that Yashin Bhargal with grey hair, white top cap, he could be arrested in a border area if it is monitored by CCTV. This is my thinking, you know. So, now to Chandler should be interrogated, taken into the lair, into a small room, if he is suspected. The second one, the next one, you need to be myself. Why not to introduce the ID card system in between Nepal and India to obstruct the terrorists, to obstruct the criminals, because the criminals commit crime in India and they buy it to the Nepalese people. This is the reciprocal India. So if we introduce an ID card system, at least 50% of the criminal activity would be stopped. 50%, I'm not telling you to 100%, but 50% would be stopped. You know, according to my study, Canada and USA, they have the open border in there. But if one Canadian goes to USA, he has to produce at least the driving license, as IDD, identity. For the Canadians, for the USA, is the similar thing. I guess this is my thing. So, last one, why not to make the fencing in between Nepal and India? But I have a reservation that Nepal and India have 1,880 kilometer long border, but there should have at least 360 exceeded entry points. The barrier, the fencing should not be installed all the way around, but they should have 360 exceeded entry. Because Robert Frost, American poet, he has said that good fences make good neighbors. If we have to be good neighbors, we have to install the fencing, a barbed wire fencing. Because, you know, Bangladesh and India have an 856 kilometer long barbed wire. And Pakistan and India have installed the iron fencing, you know. They are respecting from both the sides. So, what is this? It is not the time to be with visa between Nepal and India. According to my study, visa is not necessary. We don't have to introduce visa system in Nepal and India because we have a very good relation with India. So, conclusion, this is my last slide. So, you know, the most important thing is we have to work on the following mechanisms of visa. Common Action Program to be accelerated by the North-South Connectivity. Nepal lies in the northern side, India in the southern side. So they should have north-south dialogue to both the challenges of the cross-border movement and also a further develop other cooperation between the security people of both the countries. And last one is exchange of real-time information. If there is any incident on one side of the border, the information should be passed at hand on the other side of the frontier. So this will be the mechanism, this is the mechanism to cope the challenges between Nepal and India. The last one is stress not to let issue the open border. We have the open border system since century, but it has not to be misused by the unwanted people, by the terrorists, by the criminals. So, this is my thinking, this is my suggestion. Thank you very much.
Yes, I have a question.
Yes, I have a question.